The newest release of Betaflight is out, and it's had a complete overhaul. The quads that I have running it fly absolutely amazing, and this video will cover the 6 things you need to know about Betaflight 4.3. You've probably been using the same version of the Betaflight app on your computer, also known as the Configurator, for some time now. Betaflight is actually the firmware and the code that is on your flight controller, and not necessarily the app. All the Configurator does is adjust the firmware based upon what you select on the screen. And not updating to the new Configurator means you won't have access to a lot of the things that make 4.3 so great. But do you really need to update to Betaflight 4.3 and the new Configurator? After all, if your quad is flying perfectly, why fix something that isn't broken? Well, if you want the least painful experience with Betaflight, then you really need to update it. Some of the functions have moved to different parts of the app, such as configuring your receiver is now in the receiver tab, and configuring your motor protocol is now in the motor protocols tab, which just is more intuitive. There are also a bunch of other cool features in things 2, 3, and 4, plus a couple of things that you need to watch out for later on in 5 and 6. If you don't update the configurator to the newest version, which is 10.8, then you risk cooking your flight controller, ESC, or motors if you try to run Betaflight 4.3. I've been running the Karate Race tune on my racing builds and the Superfly Freestyle tune on my freestyle builds, and they both fly absolutely amazing. Tuning on previous versions of Betaflight was an absolute pain because it was a combination of science as well as dark arts to get a quad to fly great. Plus, it has a steep learning curve. A beginner playing around with the PIDs when they have no clue what they're doing can spell absolute disaster. In later versions of 4.2, the sliders were added to help make it easier for most pilots to tune their quads. But whether you are a beginner or have a good idea of what you are doing, there are 2 ways to tune your quad. If you're more experienced with tuning, you can go to the PID tuning tab and work your magic with the sliders, or if you prefer the older method, you can too. But the easiest way I have found to tune a quad is to use one of the many preset tunes. Whether it's the Karate Race tune or the Superfly Freestyle tune, they work absolutely amazing. They're also official tunes, and you do have access to some community tunes as well. If you're more experienced with PID tuning and you want to play around with the sliders, the magic under the hood in the PID controller has changed, so you are going to need to read the release notes to get up to speed with those specific changes. When it comes to setting up a quad, previously you'd have to hunt all around the internet to try to find someone's tune, the VTX tables, or someone else's rates that you wanted to try. And it's just an absolute pain in the butt and is a lot more difficult than necessary. The presets tab is your new best friend, and it's got you covered from everything from preset tunes to another pilot's rates, VTX tables, setup, or under the hood settings for your radio link. Now, is there any real benefit to using presets? Absolutely. When I have a brand new quad and want to apply a preset tune, set up HD0, my rates, or add under the hood magic for Express LRS, I go through and select all the different presets that I need and hit save and reboot, and they're all applied in one hit. It is that simple. But you do need to watch out, as a lot of these preset tunes will have certain requirements like RPM filtering that you need to have running to avoid smoking an ESC or burning out a motor. Then when it comes to configuring your setup, if you've built a brand new quad, most of the time you're going to need to make sure each of the motors spin the right way, otherwise you're just going to flip out. Now, I don't mean setting the prop direction either. Previously, to get your motors spinning in the right direction, you'd have to go to either the B-Heli configurator or resolder two of the wires to the different pads on the ESC. Now, it is completely unnecessary and really simple to do. Also, if your ESC wasn't in the correct orientation, your motors would be out of order, which you'd then have to change in the CLI by doing resource remapping. Can you still do it through BL Heli? Yes, but should you? Well, that really comes down to what you find easier, and for me, doing it in Betaflight when I'm going through and setting up everything else just makes it a lot easier. If you do it in Betaflight, here is how. First, take your props off. Then, for reordering motors, click the Reorder Motors button and follow the wizard. For changing your motor direction, click the Motor Direction button, and you can either do it manually or follow the prompts with the wizard. Again, really, really simple. Whenever you're doing any motor configuration or you have your quad on the bench, do take your props off. You don't need to be butchered if something does go wrong. The next one on the list caught me off guard when I first came across it, and I even thought that I had a defective flight controller. That's because the gyro on our flight controllers is changing, and this impacts how we set up and tune our quads. And I wasn't sure I was actually doing it right when I first saw this. Our flight controllers have used the MPU 6000 gyro to keep our quads in the air and flying for quite a long time. However, that specific gyro has now been discontinued and manufacturers have moved to using other gyros. What the real impact of the change in gyro means for us is how frequently the gyro tells the flight controller what position your quad is now at a lower frequency than before. Because the gyro frequency is lower, the PID loop, which is the process of making sure the motors respond the way they should, also needs to run at a lower frequency. Now, whether this is a good thing or a bad thing that new gyros have a lower refresh rate, we really have our hands tied because it's what the manufacturers can get their hands on. In the configuration tab under system configuration, you'll notice that depending on the gyro update frequency can be locked to 3.2 kHz, and the maximum PID loop is also 3.2 kHz. Now, this may seem like a massive step backwards, but unfortunately, it's the hand we've all been dealt, and we can't actually change it. When updating between different versions of Betaflight, for most of the time you've been able to copy your CLI across from one version to the other. However, doing this in Betaflight 4.3 can be quite hazardous for your quad. With 4.3, all of the magic that goes into making your quad fly is vastly different from previous versions. But there are a few things to consider. Why would you want to update to 4.3 if your quad flies great, if it's on a previous version? And is there anything that I can copy across, or do I have to start again? If you do want to migrate across, there is a tool that you can use, and I'll cover that shortly. But I do prefer to start again and have a clean setup. To migrate across, you can use Roberto Domenico's Safe Migrator, where you can paste the CLI of a previous version of Betaflight, and then it gives you a safe diff that you can load into Betaflight 4.3. If you decide to start again, there's a couple of little things that I do to make my life a lot easier. The first is to take a screenshot of the ports tab, and the second is to take a screenshot of the board and sensor alignment. It just makes setting up a quad from scratch a lot easier. Now, one key change you do need to be aware of when doing your tuning is you do need to set the ESC and motor protocol according to the gyro and processor on your flight controller. If you have one of the new gyros, which is limited to 3.2 kHz, you must select DShot 300 as your motor protocol, regardless of the processor. However, if you have a flight controller with an MPU 6000 gyro, this allows you to adjust the frequency between 4K and 8K, and then it's actually dependent on your processor. For F4 flight controllers, you want to run a 4K update frequency with DShot 300, and for F7 flight controllers, you want to run 8K with DShot 600. Now, I know I've said under the hood and magic many times throughout this video because there are so many changes to how the firmware works when it comes to making your quad fly great. There are a lot of little and major changes, and for the average user, these make it feel like magic to get a great flying quad. If you don't believe me, watch this video here to see how I took an $84 quad, put Betaflight 4.3 on it, and made it fly absolutely amazing. Also, this video is brought to you by the Everything Micro FPV store, where you can buy FPV related merch to help support the channel. I'm Darren from Everything FPV. Until next time, don't forget to send it.